mining done. Let's actually go the right direction though to do it. Oh, I still need a shovel. Let's see here. Oh my gosh, I can't spell. Hey, yeah, so I can't spell good, guys. So when you see messed up words that look like they should probably be a real word, please feel free just to, you know, not tell me about it. Because I hear about it all the time. I know it's misspelled. I'm working my best. Oh, she's gonna make me make my own. Alright, I guess we gotta go make a shovel. That's alright. It doesn't hurt to go do, make your own things. And the saga takes a long time to get out of here anyways. The real question is, do I remember how to, what the heck is that guy doing? What's up, dude? Why don't you go over there in that fire, right here? Come get me over here. Really? He just walked right around that. He gave me 25 cents. So that's one thing I'll have to look into is if the money conversion, like what the money conversion is, like is it 4 quarters to a dollar? Can you do that? Is it going to actually make you go to an ATM to do that? ATMs look like they are farther into the game than just, you know, being able to do it, have one. I mean, like, it don't bother me to have a lockbox with, you know, 10,000 quarters in it, but it makes it kind of annoying that, I mean, I guess once you get an ATM, you probably have to make like a in-game account, or maybe it links to your login or something, so that when you log into the server, it remembers that you have so much money, and then you put the coins in to the ATM, and when you draw the money out, it just draws it out accordingly. Like, hey, you put in 4 quarters, you have a dollar worth of. You have a dollar, so then when you pull out a dollar, it gives you a dollar rather than giving you 4 quarters. That would be super helpful. Alright, so come over here. Let's do this real quick. Dirt, stone, arrow. Oh, I have 2 cents there, too. also learning all of the pre-smelted ores before I, and then also the after-smelted ores, so that way, like, you know, there's no real purpose to it. I mean, it's, if you learn, it's just like, oh, hey, I want to learn, I want to pull out this unsmelted ore, so you can, and then you can, you know, do with it what you will, or you could just get this already smelted ingot and do whatever it is you're going to do. I don't know why I do it that way. I just do. Like, I mean, I think. Let's see. A 10 ingot is 256. Oh. Uh-oh. I think we crashed. Yep. We just had the full server meltdown. Well, that's kind of, that's sad. Let's see if we can, a ticking entity. So that means that a something is where it's not supposed to be, apparently. Super awesome. Well, oh no, what shall I do while she's fixing that? All right, should be starting back up. Also, I'd like to just tell anybody that might be watching or that is watching, yeah, thanks for coming and watching me play some Minecraft. Feel free to download the Sunday Miners mod pack. It is located on the Twitch Curse app. It is just been updated to the 5.0. Feel free to, you know, put it on, give it a shot. If you're in the stream and you want to join up on our home base server, then feel free, and I can send you over the ID for it, the IP for it, so that way you can join us and play with us. If you do want to join with us on the server, it is extreme family friendly. We have four kids that are always running around, looking over shoulders, watching us play, listening to what we're saying. So if you jump on and you see anybody on, be alert that they do probably have children. Some of them do, some of them don't. But we are very, very plus side to the family orientation. We'll put the whitelist on and start only letting people through if we start having issues with people being inappropriate on the server. That's why I said I would put it up if they want it. Yeah, our server also runs just over 170 mods. Oh, it's over 200? Okay, so our server runs over 200 mods. I don't... don't have any idea how much a Feed the Beast server runs. I don't know how much Infinity or Beyond runs. But our server is very girthy. And it, even on, like, I don't have a superior setup by any means. But it does take, it takes a bit to run it. All right, we are back up. Oh, what's that say? It's April Fool's for the month of April. Enjoy the April Fool's pet, but be warned that he is quite unpredictable. Recipe here. Thank you for downloading Mr. Crayfish's Furniture Mod. So they gave an April Fool's pet, huh? It's not April yet. It's still got like 2 weeks. I think they're trying to get the kicks in early on us is what they're doing. Alright. Let me see if I got any wood. Oh! Burnt marshmallows. Can I has one? Ha ta ta! I know they're hot. Oh my god. Burnt marshmallows are the best. Sorry about that. I got distracted by a burnt marshmallow. It was so delicious. Of course I don't have any wood. So, good thing there is a forest right here. That, oh, wow. And that volcano is erupting. Mm-hmm. I'm probably burning my forest down. Those are really good. I don't know. For some... I just saw wood, guys. You guys just all saw me get wood. Can't believe you'd watch like that.
And here you said it was family-friendly.
It is family-friendly. It's still family friendly. The kids are sleeping right now.
Yes, but if somebody else is not.
Well, then I'm sorry. Be careful with Vein Miner in the forest. If the leaves are interconnecting or if the trees are close enough, I think it's... Is it one block?
What?
Is it one or two blocks? They have to be touching? Or because
sure.
I have seen things that are catty corner of each other go.
Yeah, they're touching.
Okay. So if the trees are touching, I think also if the leaves are touching and you use Vein Miner, it will pull all of that. And you have to be careful with it because it uses your hunger. try to put everything that'll go in this table in here. I am the terror that flaps in the night. That's the server admin! Oh god! She'll give you things or take things away. She really will. She'll take things away. Thank you. I've ever used a wood anything in this game. Even when I played vanilla for so long, I don't think I ever actually used a wood anything. I always went directly to using my hands to get at least stone until I could get iron. Once I get my diamond, I can actually make these ones. These ones got gave to me in the Explorer's Pack when you start, so that way you can justifiably do something without breaking a pick or a hatchet or whatever, like, you know, bam bam, I hit a tree, it's broken. Oh wait, I have to punch it with my fist until my fists are bleeding. That seems kind of ridiculous. What it is. A diamond magically appeared in my inventory. Bum, bum, bum. The great creator has given. Yeah, as you can see, diamonds cost 40. One diamond costs 8,000 EMC. Once you get a EMC flower belt, 8,000 EMC is not a problem anymore. 100,000 EMC becomes a doesn't become a problem anymore. You basically have no issues anymore with EMC. But I'm trying to work through that process rather than just go taking from her EMC right from the get-go. Because then that kind of defeats the purpose of showing, you know, this process. Which, if you watch any of my other videos on my YouTube channel, I've done this process numerous times because of the numerous resets and whatnot. But it's still nice just to be able to remember how to do it, I guess, with the actual thing. Instead of just being like, hey, I've done this 500 times, guys, so let's not do that ever again. show. Like, come on. Well, I guess if I had anybody actively in here, I would be more like, hey, should I use this diamond and just go ahead and make my table? Or should we go back to mining and do that and get it the legit way? I think I'm just going to do it this way this time, because I might be doing a whole ton of mining later, and I don't think anybody wants to sit here and watch me fight with the mining anyway, so, oh god, how did I put this back in there? Excuse me. There's two ways to use the Philosopher's Stone. There's the... Wow! There's a freaking rhino right there! That's a... Yep, that's what I figured. That is one of the zoo mods. They added rhinos, giraffes, porcupines, armadillos. Well, if we ever get to be able, ZooCraft is what it was called. When and if we get able to actually build a zoo, which is one of my things I like to try to do. I like to build the zoo, or at least help build the zoo, or try to build a zoo. Get some of the bad mobs, get some of the good mobs. I can't remember exactly. There are some mobs. It doesn't matter at all what you do. They will despawn. Ogres, Sphinx, even if you name tag them, I believe, they will still despawn because they are a hostile mob. Zombies, creepers, skeletons, a good majority. It looks like ZooCraft comes with rhinos, porcupines, hedgehogs, anteaters, giraffes, camels, geckos, gembok, and chinchillas. So, I think that in its own is pretty cool, you know, to get into that. There'll be a lot of stuff that we see in the mod pack. I mean, a lot of us are really active. like I said, as often as I can, since I'm, you know, I'm going to try to show this off to everybody so you can see it. Heck, get on the curse, the curse client, or the, Mandy actually has some of them over here already. Get on the curse client, or if you have the Twitch combination one, you can use the Twitch one and download the mod pack, play it yourself. Put yourself in God mode, do whatever you want. You can go crazy. It's really fun to learn. It's really fun to play. This mod pack specifically used to be... In the beginning, this mod pack was more a login and die type of mod pack. That's what we wanted in the beginning. But then we got there was a large quantity of people that did not like that. They wanted to be able to actually play and not just get murdered all the time. So we dumbed it. Well, we didn't dumb it down, but we took out some of the more aggressive mods to make way for some of the less aggressive mods. Which is fine. There should be a happy medium. There's nothing wrong with that. But, this is the animals that she has currently got. She's got rhinos, panda bear. Base Minecraft now. No, not panda bear. Nope, he's Dr. Zark's. No creatures. Here are the warthogs. Or no, the boars. They're not very nice. There's the anteater. Raccoon. All these deer are annoying. They sit over here and then over here is the some of the more Minecraft specific ones. The fluid cows. I don't know. I don't think a lot of people use fluid cows. I feel like that mod hasn't updated in a while, but they are extremely helpful. I mean, like this one right here is Molten Plutonium. This one's Pokefinium. This one is Invar. Pokefinium and Invar are two of the rarest metals in the game, I believe. And here we have a cow that we can get some from. Invar is not. Okay. I know Pokefinium is rare. Is extremely rare. Invar is ferrous and iron. Okay. So, Invar is more easily attained, apparently. And then plutonium comes from the reactors. It's not hard to get, but, if you need it for something and you don't want to build a reactor, then there you go. There's a fluid cow that you can use for it. There's the horses. These horses are mo creatures. Laura will have a large amount of horses. Cows. They look like woolly cows with this pack. That's funny. Sheep, pigs, chickens, duck. Turkey utility. They're pretty cool. And I believe the name tag, when you get name tags, you can use that on any non-hostile creatures to keep them from despawning. Also, the safari net, I believe it's the safari net. Also, once you put them in it and then take them out, it keeps them from despawning. And I think the golden lassos, if you have those, do the same. Also do that same thing. But I'm